2019 was a bumper year for lunar occultations, particularly occultations of Saturn, of which there were 12 visible worldwide. Four of these could be seen from South Africa, or at least from parts of South Africa. As always, the best source for locally relevant astronomical information is the Sky Guy Africa South, published by the Astronomical Society of Southern Africa. The occultation of 29 March happened early in the morning in non-ideal conditions, with daybreak starting already in some places in South Africa. The 19 June event was similar and hence not widely observed. The May 22nd occultation was visible from parts of the country, with it happening shortly after moonrise. The moon rose behind the mountains as seen from my backyard with Saturn on tow, and the occultation starting 20 minutes later. Since it happened post full moon, so-called ingress, when it disappears behind the moon, happened on the bright edge of the moon, making it difficult to photograph because Saturn is quite dim. Egress, when it reappears from behind the moon, was much easier to film. If you overexpose the moon a little, Saturn shows up even better. To photograph this, my DSLR was mounted on prime focus on my 8-inch Mead-LX90 telescope. For the 5th of August occultation, all of South Africa was well placed to see ingress, but the moon was very close to setting during egress for some parts of the country. When packing for working a week in Sutherland, I forgot that the occultation is happening while I'm there, otherwise I would have brought some gadgets to film it. Luckily I was asked to fix the Celestron Nexstar 4 SE, which I brought with me, so saw the opportunity to use it with a cell phone. I therefore slapped together this bracket and tested it on a few daytime targets. Initially I had severe vignetting, but managed to fix it by moving the phone a little away from the eyepiece. Since I did not have a tripod, an electrical pillar box in the courtyard of the hostel served as a nice pier. This time Saturn disappeared behind the dark edge of the moon, and as it approached the moon I first took a few shots with a 200mm lens until both objects entered the cell phone telescopic view. This series was taken a minute apart, showing how the moon was racing towards Saturn. Finally, ingress was photographed by taking a picture every 10 seconds. I was caught somewhat off guard by egress, a long story, and only started photographing when Saturn cleared the moon already. The cell phone did a surprisingly good job of photographing the event, combined with the sharp optics of the Celestron and the excellent seeing of the Sutherland site.